Santoski, the Executive Director of the Arts in Piedmont, Charlottesville. I want to thank you for taking your time and seeking feedback on government budget proposals. As you know, the many chapters of the Arts around the state speak on behalf of individuals with intellectual and developmental disabilities and their families who are often unable to speak out for themselves and are easily drowned out by many competing voices that speak more loudly and often carry more influence. While I recognize this recession has forced many very difficult decisions to be made, I'm asking you to consider carefully the impact of the current budget on individuals with intellectual and developmental disabilities and their families. The current wait list for community waiver services is over 7,000 people, and as you heard, is growing at the rate of 2 people every day. By 2014, the waiting list will be more than 9,000 individuals, and in the Charlottesville area alone, there are right now over 114 individuals waiting. Many of these families and families in the near future are trying to figure out how to maintain their sons and daughters in the community and provide services needed without having to quit their jobs or overburden their already overburdened family systems. We're talking about school teachers and attorneys as well as housekeepers and custodians. We're talking about families that do not want their adult children in an institution but can't figure out why the cost of institutional care is more than double the cost of community care, and why the transition in our state to total community care for 7,000 individuals has happened slowly, and that's where the greatest need is, not in the institution where only about 1,000 people reside. I also ask you to consider not reducing the eligibility of individuals for Medicaid from 300% to 200% of SSI. Many of the families we work with have a difficult time already understanding the intricacies of Medicaid and Social Security, and will not even be aware that this is an issue that they should be concerned with until it is too late. At the very least, if this reduction is approved, the impact should not be applied retroactively. Finally, when I was growing up, I was taught that one of the roles of government was to be vigilant, to advocate for and protect those who are unable to advocate or protect themselves. Individuals with intellectual and developmental disabilities are often at risk every day to find housing, employment, and community acceptance. They are often the least vocal in advocating for themselves, but the most trusting that our system